Hello everyone, I hope everyone is fine and at the pink of your health. During these uncertainties, we must make use of every available resources to stay connected and updated with the studies. We are trying our best to help you with your subjects and chapters, and we expect the same from each one of you to be sincere with your studies. Please do copy down all the notes provided to you and follow all the lectures posted on the YouTube channel. With this being said, I welcome you to the video lecture on the essay by G.B. Shaw called Freedom. Now in this video, I will explain the background of Shaw and his essay, the themes of freedom and the perspectives of G.B. Shaw on freedom. George Bernard Shaw was born in Dublin in 1856. Like most of his Anglo-Irishmen, Shaw had contributed greatly to English literature. He left school at the age of 14. He went to London in 1876 and began his literary career as a writer of unsuccessful novels. He became interested in social reform, and he was one of the founding members of Fabian Society, an organization devoted in promoting socialism. Shaw's interest in music and dramatic criticism inherited from his mother, his interest in social reform, his admiration of Wagner and Ibsen, and the influence of Samuel Butler made Shaw a playwright. He used his plays as his mouthpiece to attack the hypocrisies, complacencies, and thoughtless acceptance of all kinds of social evils. Background of the essay. G.B. Shaw's Freedom actually belongs to one of the series of radio talks delivered by him in 1935 on the BBC. He presents a fearless criticism on acceptance of freedom. As a young adult, he became interested in socialism and activism, and began to foster a lifelong interest in what he considered to be the reprehensible cultural exploitation of the working class. Shaw uses humor to hide the satire of the social condition. In his essay, Freedom, Shaw criticizes the capitalist view of freedom, where freedom of an individual can never be realized. Shaw advocates that the society must try to reach the socialist political condition gradually through the means of democracy. Shaw begins and ends his essay with a proposition that no single person is free. From the outset of the essay, Shaw asks, "What is a perfectly free person?" And he answers the question by saying that a person who can do what he likes, when he likes, and where he likes, or do nothing at all if he prefers it. Herein lies the whole summary of the essay, and Shaw merely expands upon this point and uses it as an allusion to the capitalist political system. He starts by addressing to the natural kind of slavery, gradually moving on to the unnatural kind of slavery. In the next few paragraphs, Shaw describes in detail the unnatural slavery of man by another man, which started as a form of slavery, and later on that changed into the more sophisticated kind of slavery, where you are hired and paid for the services you give. And naturally, the master class, through its parliament, schools, and newspapers, have desperately tried to prevent the people from realizing their slavery. In the next section, we will look at the perspective of Shaw's freedom. Over here, I will try to explain the few points given in this essay, the important points which will make the essay easier for you to understand. Through this essay, Shaw was attacking the capitalist political system. He was trying to advocate socialist political system through democracy. In this essay, Shaw tries to address the objectives of the governments. The objective of every government should be to prevent the unnatural slavery of man to man. But Shaw observes that instead of preventing the slavery of man to man, they end up encouraging it. The government tried to regulate the norms of slavery and tried to keep the greed of the master class in check. But this does not make the repressed class of people any more free than they were before. They merely end up choosing between one master from another. Shaw also observes that the master class end up more deluded than the common people because of the way in which they were brought up. A gentleman whose mind has been formed at a preparatory school run by the master class itself, followed by a public school run by the government, is completely under the false notion of created history and dishonest political economy and snobbery taught in these places. The kind of education which these gentlemen receive in these places makes him think highly of himself. He starts believing that he is superior to others. He thinks that this socially superior position of his gives him the right to get his work done by people less privileged. Thus, the deception meant for the commoners end up deluding the master class themselves. George Bernard Shaw says that, according to the Greek philosopher Aristotle, men are ignorant idolaters by nature, and they respect those who are superior and godlike. The law and order, as well as the government, would become miserable unless the people obey the ruling class. And the conditions which Aristotle outlined have to be fulfilled for the commoners to obey the law. Thus, the ruling class must present themselves as rich and godlike in order to attract the obedience of the commoners. Next, Shaw believes that if the laws are reasonable and administered impartially, then the citizens will have no reason to complain and they will obey the laws of the government. These same laws increases the freedom of the people by protecting them against violent assaults, highway robberies, and any disorder. There are number of ways in which the freedom of an individual gets restricted. There is the division of society into the upper class and the common people. The upper class people consider themselves to be superior than the commoners, thinking themselves to be privileged. They force the common mass to do their work. The gentleman's education makes him think highly of himself, leading him to exploit the common man, restricting the individual's freedom. The bringing in of frequent amendments in the laws of the land by the government in favor of the upper class people brings out the restrictions in freedom. And therefore, Shaw criticizes the system of vote, in which the already oppressed people are made to believe that they have been given the freedom to choose. But in reality, it is another name of exploitation. And that the right to vote only guarantees them of a choice between two sets of oppressors. The situation of a slave class remains unchanged. And another way in which the freedom of the individual is restricted by the upper class is that The master class very cunningly, through its parliament, schools and newspapers, makes the most desperate efforts to prevent the slaves from realizing their slavery. These were the few important points which G.B. Shaw has addressed in his essay. I hope this lecture proves beneficial in understanding the essay. Thank you.